let's understand concepts so that we could be able to answer any question related to the male reproductive system. In this diagram, we see that it is labeled bladder. We then have an A, B, C, D, and E. So write down the letter, very important to take note of what it is they are asking for. So in this question, so I just want to jump into my black pen. You're asking for the letter and the name. All right. So remembering we have letter A, B, C, D, and E. And then we're just going to put the corresponding name to it. All right. So the first one forms part of, so either you can label, so label A, B, C, and D, so you have all the answers in front of you. Then go back into the diagram and see where in the diagram those certain labels correspond with what you have. That's one way to do it. Another way is let's see exactly what they want, and that's the letters we're going to use. So forms part of both the urinary and reproductive system. All right, so if you look at the diagram, you see the bladder goes into a little pipey. And also you see that the two ones that come out of the testes also come as if they're also coming into this pipe. So obviously what we're talking about is the urethra that would obviously be used for both urinary and reproductive systems. So then my answer would be black, sorry. So then it would be A would be the letter would be C, and what we're talking about is our urethra. The next one storms sperm temporarily. So obviously now we understand that sperm is created during spermogenesis within the testes, within the egg. So as the eggs mature, obviously from LH and luteinizing hormone, then the testes make sperm and the sperm then moves up. But we must then remember that sperm can go into a place and not yet be released. So where they would be sitting temporarily, meaning not for long, would actually be our, so if you look on the diagram, out of the testes, you have like a little cap over the testes. You kind of see that? That little cap would be our epididymis, and that's where it would be sitting, all right? So B would be that letter B, and that would have been our epididymis, all right? And the last question says secretes testosterone. Okay, so again, we're understanding luteinizing hormone and FSH work inside the testes. One of the things they release, not just a matured sperm, but also testosterone. So testosterone would work directly within the testes, which would then be at place E, which would be our testes. All right. So then it says identify part A. So part A would be our prostate gland. So the prostate gland actually sits behind that tube. And so that's why when you have an inflamed prostate, it kind of squeezes. And that's why people with like prostate cancer or anything in that region could also struggle, not just with reproduction, but also with urinary, you know, because we understand how close that urethra is actually sitting with our prostate, all right? So the question, again, to repeat it, identify part A, which is the prostate gland. So 1.4.2.A, it's a prostate gland. Okay. And then B, the type of gemato, so obviously our gametes, genesis that takes place at place E. So within the testes, we know we'd only be dealing with two, oogenesis or spermogenesis. So in this case, because it's in the male, we are spermatogenesis. So it's sperms getting generated. All right.